curses are something prevalent we see in the Pirates of the Caribbean lore, with some turning the victims into skeletons or even humanoid sea creatures. One of the more known curses is the Aztec Curse of Cortez, a curse laid upon Cortez's own treasure. This very treasure would be given to Hernan Cortez by the Aztec people as a method of keeping Cortez at bay and to stop him from looting their lands and killing their people. In about 1519, the Aztec Empire would provide Hernan with a stone chest containing 882 Aztec gold coins, though this treasure would be cursed by the heathen gods in response to Cortez's sheer greed and refusal to cease hostility towards the Aztec Empire. This very chest would be housed in the caves of Isla de Muerta, and any mortal who happened to steal a piece of gold from the chest would be cursed until its return, and the gods are repaid via a sacrifice of blood. Hundreds of years after the initial curse, before the events of the first film, Jack Sparrow, aboard the Black Pearl, would set out on his expedition of searching for the treasure despite all the rumors that the gold was cursed. Though unaware of how lucky he actually was, he would be mutinied upon by his crew, including Hector Barbosa, who would now captain the Black Pearl, and left stranded on an island. While stranded there, Barbosa and the crew would set sail for Isla de Muerta and take from the chest of Cortez, considering the rumors warning travelers of the curse to be ridiculous superstition. However, they would soon discover that the curse was real, and they would take skeletal forms of themselves under the light of the moon. After finally returning 881 pieces of the gold, they realized they were missing one final piece. In addition, they didn't learn of the blood sacrifice required until they had already sent Bootstrap Bill, a member of the crew who stole from the chest, to the bottom of the ocean, now aware that every single person who stole had to sacrifice blood. However, a revelation would occur to them, and hope of returning to their former lives was still on the table, and all they had to do was acquire the blood of Bill Turner's son, who also happened to possess the final piece of Aztec gold. After storming Port Royal in 1728, the crew of the Black Pearl would find that Elizabeth Swan now owned the gold medallion, the piece of gold that she took from Will Turner, Bootstrap's son, prior. She would tell them that her last name was Turner, leading them to believe that she was the child of Bill Turner, taking her to the Isla de Muerta to lift their curse. This, however, would not work, as she was not related to the Turner family, resulting in the crew finally discovering Will Turner and attempting to use his blood to free themselves. After an altercation with Jack Sparrow and Will against Barbosa and the crew, Will would spill his own blood and drop the medallion in the chest of Cortez, lifting the curse at last. Though in the process, Barbosa would be shot by Jack Sparrow and seemingly die, having been resurrected later on, as we know. The former crew under Barbosa would return to the chest and seal the gold once again after fleeing capture from the British Royal Navy, desiring to exact their revenge against Captain Jack Sparrow. Jack the Monkey would also remain cursed as he took from the chest as well. To clarify, the curse would only affect those who actually took from the chest of Cortez, hence why Elizabeth and Will before her were not cursed. Moving on, we have the Curse of the Muertos Moon, a curse created by the mysterious Jolly Roger. Jolly Roger would attempt to use this wicked curse on every pirate in the Caribbean, using it October 31st on All Hallows Eve, more commonly known as Halloween. Under the full moon, all pirates would now serve Jolly Roger if they stepped foot on land in the moonlight. However, Roger's plans would be thwarted by none other than Captain Jack Sparrow, who would steal an ancient Aztec relic known as the Moonstone from one of Jolly Roger's servants, using it to ensure that those at sea would not fall under the effects of the curse. Those on land would have to fight the undead under the curse until enough are defeated, breaking the curse at last. Another curse that many pirates believe to be simply a myth would be the Curse of the Devil's Triangle, a rocky area located in the Caribbean Sea and west of the Windward Islands in the Lesser Antilles. In the year 1708, Captain Salazar of the Spanish Royal Navy would hunt down Jack Sparrow and the crew of the Wicked Wench in this very location, as part of his quest to exterminate piracy across the high seas, though he would be tricked into his demise by a young Jack Sparrow as the sharp rocky formations carved through the hull of the Silent Mary, plunging the crew, along with Armando Salazar, to the crushing depths. However, Salazar and his crew would be resurrected at the cost of being cursed and their bodies being left in the state they were in their dying moments, whether it be part of their facial region missing or one or several of their limbs. Captain Salazar and his crew would hunt down Jack Sparrow not only for revenge, but for the compass he possessed, as it would lead them to what they desired most, their freedom. The only known way to break this curse would be to destroy the Trident of Poseidon, an ancient weapon that held the key to every maritime curse. As many of you may already know, the Trident would be destroyed by Will Turner's son Henry, and the curse would be lifted, though Salazar and his men would ultimately perish after a battle against Jack, Barbosa, Henry, and the rest of the crew accompanying them. Finally, we have what is likely the most infamous curse, this of course being the Curse of the Flying Dutchman. Sometime between the early and mid-17th century, a sailor named Davy Jones, captain of the Flying Dutchman, would fall in love with a goddess called Calypso, and she would bestow upon Jones the duty of ferrying souls lost at sea to a world beyond death. However, with this curse, Davy Jones could only set foot on land every 10 years, and when it came time for him to do so and meet up with his love Calypso, she was nowhere to be found. Feeling betrayed by the woman he loved dearly and who he believed loved him in return, Jones would cast aside his duties and instruct the first brother in court on how to bind Calypso to her human form, allowing pirates and men to own the sea. This choice would lead to Jones and his crew being transformed into sea creature-esque monsters forced to roam the seas for eternity. Subsequently, Davy Jones would carve out his heart and put a spell of sorts on it, stating that he who stabbed the heart would take his place. His heart would be locked in the dead man's chest, buried in a secret location known only to Jones. This is, of course, until Jack Sparrow and Will Turner discover the key and chest and unlock it, with Will eventually stabbing the heart and taking Davy Jones' place as captain of the Flying Dutchman, as the Dutchman must always have a captain, and ferrying souls of those lost at sea to the afterlife, much like Jones had to. This curse would be broken, however, after the aforementioned trident is destroyed, breaking every curse at sea. Anyhow, I hope you enjoyed this video. I plan on making more Pirates content soon, so look out for that. Have a great day. See ya.